This is it. The Nomad for 2021. I have not seen it yet, but from everything I've seen on the computer, it's gonna be the best graphic ever.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
White.
That's dope, huh? Clear on the sides. 150, what size is this? 155. The sweet spot right in the middle.
Who did that one?
Carson did this one. Carson Weiser, one of our homeboys in the art department at Slingshot. Just a super clean kind of flare on this board this year. Orange sidewalls, white base. This is sick, I'm excited to try it. This board has been super fun behind the boat the last few years. Having something bigger, probably never thought 10 years ago I'd ride a 155. Some people still don't think it's possible, but it is like the absolute most fun behind the boat to get out and ride something big and just kind of boost and get floaty with it. And you know, it's like longboard surfing, but behind the boat. No barrels on this one, but plenty of steezy turns and airs. Yeah, pretty turn around. I can't tell if it's like, it's got like a cool like finish on it, huh?
It's almost like matte.
You see that? It's like matte here and then glossy through the center and then matte again. Sustainably sourced wood. That's always a good thing. Full wood core, as you can see. So that's the secret to all the pop, soft landings, getting that magic amount of flex.
So there's actually wood in it? It's not just a graphic?
It's not a wood graphic. It's really wood inside of the entire board. You know when you're like riding and you just look down and your gear looks good and all of a sudden you're like, kind of a thing, you know? We created the Nomad in 2015, and the whole idea behind it was to make a board that was fun to ride, easy to ride. You don't necessarily have to have a monster wake to use it. So making the surface area larger gives you more pop, more stability, and almost feels like a freaking sail in the wind. Like you just pop up behind the boat and feels like you can just really drift and slow down your spins and grabs and just kind of have fun with a different kind of feel. There's not really an expectation to go out and do 900 and stuff all the time, which most people aren't doing. So if you just love to wakeboard and want to have fun with some simple moves and grabs, this is, you know, the board that just kind of makes it fun and easy. So it's been tons of success the past few years. A lot of guys using it on the cable as well. So really this is the board that started the whole longboard revolution that we're kind of experiencing in wake right now. So pretty big size range there. You can see the 55 right here. This one to me is my favorite. It's just kind of the sweet spot right in the middle. Makes it super fun to grab the tail, grab the nose. They're easier to reach because they're a little bit, you know, closer to you with that additional length. Makes a tall, lanky dude like me look a little bit more proportional on the water. So just keeps things fun and interesting. So hopefully we can show you how it's done. First time I rode it, I just found how much fun, like, I mean, even to go out and like take the fins off of this thing and just cruise, like there's just simple things that you take for granted wakeboarding behind the boat, and this board to me with the flex and the length and the simplicity just kind of reminds you of how fun it is to do the simple things. Yeah, that thing looks pretty beautiful.